It's our big story. Delhi's Nizamuddin has emerged as India's largest hotspot for COVID-19. The area has now been cordoned off after reports reached the police that at least 200 people there were showing symptoms of COVID-19. Now, more than 2,000 delegates, including those from Indonesia and Malaysia, had attended a Tablighi Jamaat congregation in Nizamuddin West from March 1st to March 15th. 10 people who had attended the event have died of COVID-19 across 4 states and 1 union territory. The Delhi government has said that strong action will be taken against those who were in charge of this congregation. Meanwhile, at least 1,500 people from Tamil Nadu were reported to have attended this seminar. The Tamil Nadu government currently has traces for less than 1,000 people and is asking all those people who attended the congregation to identify themselves. Andhra Pradesh is also saying that at least 369 of its people had attended the Jamaat. Let me go straight across to our reporters who are joining us on the big story. Sneha Mordani tracks the health ministry for us. She's joining us live on the broadcast. Runjun Sharma is live with us from Delhi. Purnima live with us from Chennai. And Radhika is live with us from Mumbai. Runjun, I'm coming to you first. You know, inside the hostel of the Jamaat, we believe there were some 1,500 to 1,700 people. Have all of them been evacuated? How many of them are showing symptoms of COVID-19? And how many have died?
No, Shreya, all of them, in fact, have not been evacuated from the Markaz building. As we speak, there are hundreds of people who are still trapped inside the building. I spoke to the Nizamuddin Dargah Sharif custodian, and he was telling me that they had tried to reach out to the police around 25th of March, saying that we are trapped in, you know, inside this building. And as we speak, Shreya, there are still hundreds of people who are inside this building. And of course, you know, they've come in contact with COVID-19 patients, and now, you know, words like social distancing don't make sense inside of a building when hundreds of people are there inside anymore. Shreya, out of these people, you know, few people, over 200 people have been taken to different hospitals in Delhi, three particular hospitals I'm talking about. Over 200 people have been tested. The results for most of the people are awaited yet. But for now, 24 people, I can tell you, have been tested positive from the Nizamuddin Markaz building. And of course, Shreya, another thing important to underline here is that these people who are in the building, they're in the building post the lockdown. But before that, when I spoke to the Dargah Sharif custodian, he was telling me that it's a very real possibility that after attending the congregation, they went to different mosques also in the city. So contact tracing here is going to be a big challenge.
Okay. Sneha Mordani, you know, this is a nightmare. This is a nightmare, and state governments across the country will now have to be overactive in the next 24 hours to contact trace every person who had attended the congregation.
Absolutely, and thank God for the already up and running integrated disease surveillance program. It's an old program, Shreya, that has been in fact working towards eliminating infectious disease in India, not just COVID-19. I've been telling you all that there is reorientation that has been done for this program, and for this very reason there is a team of two people that goes. In fact, the team comprises of two people, but in the case of Nizamuddin, where there is a huge cluster outbreak, there are going to be more teams that are going to be deployed. This is going to be the plan. The way the government handles a cluster outbreak is very different from the way a government handles imported cases and local cases of transmission. India has seen several cluster outbreaks, but looking at the geographical spread of this and looking at the number of people who could have been impacted, not just the number of people who right now turned positive, but the number of people who could have who can in fact be turning positive. Many of them would be asymptomatic, but they can turn positive even after 14 days. We know that. It is the biggest cluster outbreak in the country. The micro plan for containing local transmission of corona diseases, COVID-19, is the program that is run by the government of India, particularly the Integrated Surveillance Disease Program. What they do is that they cordon off the entire area. Then they start surveillance. What they do is that they pick people who have underlying conditions like pneumonia, influenza-like illness, high-risk population, senior citizens, people with comorbidities, underlying healthcare conditions, and test them. You know, just there is testing which is done. There is massive quarantine operations that take place. Whether they're going to be kept at home and that is going to be strictly enforced, or whether they're going to be taken to a separate location, we just don't know. We do know that 200 people were taken by the Delhi police yesterday itself. They were taken because of the fear that they could be transmitting the infection. Sources within the government also say that for every one positive COVID-19 patient, there could be up to at least 14 people around him who could have been infected. So for one case, there could be 14. Imagine 2,000 people, in fact, attended this religious congregation and just didn't stay in Delhi. These people also traveled back to their respective states and countries, to Telangana, to Jammu and Kashmir, to Karnataka, to Maharashtra. I mean, it's going to be a daunting task to, in fact, track the number of people who have this infection, you know, get to test all of them. The surveillance, the rapid testing surveillance is going to start roughly around the 2nd of April is what I'm picking up, because the 5 lakh kids are going to arrive. And it is going to be an exhaustive sort of a process, really, to get in touch with just so many people. And right now it's imperative for those people who have come in contact with these people attending the congregation to come forward and help the government, really. And I think this is going to be a very, very difficult task before the government. The also fact is that the Indian Council of Medical Research had a strict protocol in place for anybody returning from a foreign destination, saying that you have to be in quarantine, self-quarantine for at least 14 days. That protocol has also been violated by many people, Malaysians, Indonesians, who had in fact attended this congregation in Nizamuddin around the 10th of March.
So right now across Telangana, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Jammu, Kashmir, Maharashtra, all those places where our reporters are currently spread, what the government is asking is asking people who were part of this congregation to come forward and identifying them, because that makes their task that much easier. Let me go across to Revathi Rajivan, who is joining us from Bangalore. Revathi, what is the update that you're getting from the Tamil Nadu government? I beg your pardon, from the Karnataka government.
Well, so far, Karnataka government has been able to trace only two cases to this particular incident, this particular congregation. One is the death of that 60-year-old man in Tumkur in Karnataka. He died on 27th March, and his movements history was also sort of a concern, because from the congregation, he returned to Bengaluru in a train, and from Bangalore to Tumkur, he took a bus. So public transportation, and from there on, he interacted with many people as well. And these home quarantine rule did not apply to him because he did not have a foreign travel history. He did not have contact with any positive patients. So until he showed symptoms and he was tested positive, he was going about his life like any other person. Now, yesterday, a 13-year-old child tested positive. This child is the son of that man who died on 27th March. So two people who have tested positive in Karnataka with relation to this particular congregation that we're talking about. And those two are the only cases from Tumkur district that has come out at this point of time. Now, the government has not put out the number of people they have traced, but after the death of that 60-year-old man on 27th March, the government put out the movement history showing where all he had traveled, the train, the train that he had taken, and also the bus that he had taken, as well as the private hospital he had visited. So at that point of time, there were 24 high-risk contacts that the government had traced, and there were also, this also included medical professionals, doctors and nurses, because when he showed symptoms 4 days after he arrived, he was first taken to a private hospital, then a district hospital. He was discharged from there against medical advice, again went to a private hospital, and when the symptoms worsened, he went back to the district hospital. That is where he died on 27th March. So through all this time, he has been interacting with people, doctors, nurses, other people, family members as well. So there could be several people who may have come in contact with him. But at this point of time, the government has released only reports of two people which have turned positive in relation to this particular incident. But we do not have any other cases so far in Karnataka that have tested positive with relation to this particular congregation. In the coming days, with more tests and the tracing of other contacts, possibly we'll have those numbers.
Okay, Radhika, you are reporting to us from Mumbai. The number of positive cases in Maharashtra has gone up to 30. There are 5 new cases that have been reported today. Do we know how many people, you know, need to be contact traced as far as the state of Maharashtra is concerned that have links to Nizamuddin?
Yes, absolutely. There are many who had to be contact traced at the moment. The latest update as far as the Nizamuddin tracing is concerned in Mumbai and Navi Mumbai, there is one more update that we've got from the health department here, that one more person who was in touch with the Filipino man. Remember, in Maharashtra, there is one 68-year-old man from Philippines who had attended that congregation, had died on March 22nd. And he did that, there was a group of 10 who had attended it. Of that group of 10, two people apart from him has also tested positive. Those two are still in Kasturba Hospital. The Filipino man died. These people, these group of 10, were in Vashi, Navi Mumbai, in a mosque. They were staying in a mosque, and the Maulana of that mosque, the priest, has also tested positive. Apart from him, his son, his grandson and his maid have all tested positive. This happened over the last couple of days. Now, today, the latest update that we got from the health department is that another individual, a resident of Vashi, who was in touch with the Filipino man, he had taken him to a medical store. He had taken him in his car. That's the information we got. So who was in touch with the Filipino man has just tested positive, and he got admitted in Kasturba Hospital last night. So there are additional cases that are turning positive as well. The total number, you know, as far as the Nizamuddin incident, Maharashtra is concerned, is 3 plus 4, 7 plus the latest one, 8. So 8 people have tested positive and one has died.
What a nightmare this is turning out to be. Praveen Swamy's group consulting editor joining us on the broadcast as well. Praveen, what do we know about this Tablighi Jamaat? And, you know, how can an organization be this irresponsible? I'm sure you have read the press release that they have now issued saying we had no option. The lockdown was announced suddenly and we were asked to stay where we were. We were 2,000 of us. What could we do? We could not move out because all rail lines had stopped. Are you buying that sort of justification that is coming in from the Jamaat?
Well, let me answer the first part of your question first. The Tablighi Jamaat is one of the largest proselytizing religious groups in the world. It has giant congregations every winter in Raiwind in Pakistan. It was founded more than 100 years ago in India, and it basically calls on followers to gather in these large groups and then go out and proselytize, preach Islam in mosques and in villages around the country and around the world. So it does draw tremendous amounts of followers, huge amounts of people. And to anyone who was following the newspapers in January or February, it should have been abundantly clear that there were public health concerns there. Now, it's true, as the Tablighi Jamaat says, that there wasn't a formal government health warning prior to that date in March. But like I said, for any educated or reasonably sensible person, not to have acted and dispersed the assemblies this year strikes me personally as extremely irresponsible. Having said that, we've seen through this epidemic unfolding that similar acts of irresponsibility have been critical. You'll recall that a single church in South Korea sparked off the worst of the epidemic over there. We've seen quite responsible political figures participate in various kinds of pujas and religious functions, even parties, right through this behavior. It seems to me that the lesson we should really draw from this is that private entities, whether they're religious, whether they're large crowds, need to start displaying a far greater sense of responsibility. Even if the government didn't issue an official warning as informed citizens, you ought to have the minimum sense to act on the information that you're getting and avoid irresponsible behavior. In this case, sadly, that didn't happen.
You know, in the U.S. already, they're talking about if there's anyone who is spreading coronavirus deliberately, then the Terror Act, Anti-Terrorism Act, will apply to them. My question to you is this. There's already talks of an FIR in Delhi against the Jamaat. Is that something that is going to hold? Is that something that should be priority right now? to possibly set an example, or is the immediate concern to ensure that there is contact tracing done and as soon as you can, do the containment so that it doesn't spread? This strain that has come out from Nizamuddin doesn't spread anymore. It's already spread to four states and one union territory, but at least it can stop there and doesn't go anywhere else.
I think what we're seeing is a very large number of people behaving quite irresponsibly to their own loved ones and to the society around them. The Tablighi Jamaat case in Nizamuddin is one, but we've also seen numbers of extremely educated, affluent people like NRIs avoiding the government's repeated appeals, correct, forcing the police to chase after them across their state. I think there is a case now for the government to crack down on some of these cases and to make clear that irresponsible behavior will have very, very serious consequences. We're seeing governments in Europe and the United States do this. Forget deliberate spreading. I don't think there can be very many people today who can argue that they are unaware of what the government and what society is asking them to do.
Correct.
And if they persist in defying these rules and putting other people, other human beings at risk because of their irresponsibility, I think they must suffer the legal consequences of doing so.
All right, Praveen, we'll leave it there for the moment. Thank you very much. I'm going across to Purnima Murli, who is joining us live from Chennai. Purnima, in your state as well, in Tamil Nadu as well, there are a large number of people who did attend the Jamaat. Does the government have their, you know, does the government have their names, their contacts, etc.? Have all of them been put in quarantine? How's it working out there?
Well, only a few hundreds have been traced so far, Shreya. The state government says that at least 1,500 people had travelled to attend the Nizamuddin gathering and the meeting that took place in the national capital. So they say that at least 1,500 people have participated, out of which only a few hundreds have been found. So far, 16 of them have tested positive. The two hotspots, the corona hotspots right now, would be Coimbatore and Erode. In Coimbatore, at least 82 people have been traced and their samples have been given to the lab for testing. In Erode as well, of the 30-odd people who've participated, at least 10 of them have tested positive. And the latest update from the National Health Commission Tamil Nadu Twitter handle says that there are 7 people today who've been tested positive, out of which 5 had participated in the Nizamuddin gathering. That's something that's the latest update that's coming in from Tamil Nadu. But Coimbatore, Erode are the hotspots, and the state government's priority right now is to trace all the 1,500 people who had participated. In fact, the district officials from Coimbatore, Madurai, Erode have appealed to people to come forward if they did participate in the meeting to ensure that the state government finds it difficult to find all the 1,500. They are now appealing to people to come forward. So that's the priority that the state government is focusing on right now. And yes, at least 16 people have been tested positive so far, and 5 more today. So that number is now stands at 21.
All right, Purnima, do stay on with us. There's a piece of breaking news that is coming in. CNN News 18 managing to access the breakup of foreigners who are present at the Jamaat event. There were 72 people from Indonesia. There were 71 people from Thailand. There were 34 people from Sri Lanka. There were 33 people from Myanmar, Kyrgyzstan, 28. There were 20 people from Malaysia. There were 19 people from Nepal. There were 19 people again from Bangladesh, and there were 14 other people as well, including from countries like England, Kuwait, Afghanistan, Algeria, Singapore, France, etc. Let me go across to Arunima, who's accessing these details for us. Arunima, it seems that contact tracing will not just need to be done across India, but possibly across the world as well.
It's a nightmare. It's a complete nightmare right now. And if community transmission happens, Nizamuddin is already a hotspot, and they could well contribute to the situation worsening for the country overall. Delhi police has managed to find out the details about people who were present. The numbers are huge. Even Markaz is accepting that after a few people were allowed to leave, there were still about 1,500 who were left back because during the lockdown. So the Delhi police police has managed to make this list, the details of which we just put out for our viewers. Now, attempts are on to track down who all these other people met. For example, 70-plus people from Indonesia, 70-plus people from Thailand. And what Markaz has told Delhi police is that after the first congregation, smaller groups were sent to other parts of the country. So they went to Uttar Pradesh, they went to Tamil Nadu, they even went to Andaman Nicobar Island. So now, who all did they meet there? How many people came in contact? It's going to be an intrastate affair now. Delhi police is trying to speak to them. Many of them are now admitted in hospital. So they're trying to speak to them, trace down, track down their contacts. But if they were speaking to religious congregation in smaller places, for example, in Uttar Pradesh or in Tamil Nadu, then it'll be difficult to track down all those people who are present in those smaller congregations as well.
Arunima, a very quick question here, a clarification for my better understanding. You've given us a list of foreigners who are present at the congregation. Where are they right now? Are they still in India? Did they manage to leave the country? Because that becomes important as well.
See, these are people, I mean, the total number was much more. These are people who are still here in the country, who are undergoing treatment, whose details Delhi police have managed to collate. The overall number was much larger. And like the Jamaat spokesperson said, I think only 1,500 could not leave the country before the lockdown happened.
All right. Then I'm assuming the, you know, the contact tracing will have to be done of people, people who've already managed to leave the country. They will have to be identified as well. Possibly foreign governments will need to be told about it as well. Thank you, Arunima. We'll leave it there for the moment. 150 people who had attended this religious congregation at Nizamuddin, they've now been taken to the LNJP hospital after they developed symptoms. Chandan is on the ground and is getting us this report.
दिल्ली के निजामुद्दीन इलाके में तबलीगी जमात के इज्तिमा ने दिल्ली में कोरोना के मामले को एक्सपोनेंशियली बढ़ा दिया है. अचानक ही बड़ी बढ़ोतरी हुई है दिल्ली में, और जो लोग वहां पर शामिल हुए थे इज्तिमा में, उनमें से 150 से ज़्यादा लोगों को दिल्ली के एलएनजेपी हॉस्पिटल में भर्ती कराया गया है. दिल्ली में सोमवार को जो मामले बढ़े, करीब 25 मामले, उनमें से 18 मामले निजामुद्दीन इलाके के इज्तिमा में शामिल हुए लोगों की थी. पिछले दिनों निजामुद्दीन इलाके में बताया जा रहा कि करीब 1400 लोग इज्तिमा में शामिल हुए, जबकि इसकी इजाज़त नहीं थी. बार बार अपील की जा रही थी कि लोग भीड़ इकट्ठा ना करें, लोग एकजुट ना हो, जमा ना हो, लेकिन ये खतरनाक स्थिति बनी. और जिस तरह से संक्रमण बढ़ा है, उसने दिल्ली के मन में एक भय ज़रूर पैदा कर दिया, एक डर ज़रूर पैदा कर दिया. और सरकार भी जो है चिंतित है, इसके लिए जो है बड़ी बैठकें हो रही कि दिल्ली में जो कुछ हुआ या देश भर में जिस तरह से मामले अचानक बढ़े हैं, उसको लेकर के और क्या क्या कदम उठाए जा सकते हैं. उधर अगर हम बात करें तो निजामुद्दीन इलाके में एनसीडी की तरफ से हर एक जो आदमी शामिल हुआ था या हर एक आसपास की बिल्डिंग को सैनिटाइज करने की कोशिश की जा रही है. तमाम तरह की कोशिशों के बीच जिस तरह से लापरवाही लोगों ने की है, उसने दिल्ली में निश्चित तौर पर कोरोना का संकट गहरा कर दिया है.
तबलीग जमात के मरकज निजामुद्दीन में मस्जिद को सैनिटाइज करने के लिए यहाँ पर एमसीडी के कर्मचारी पहुंचे हैं. आप तस्वीरों में देख सकते हैं करीब 40 लोगों की टीम यहां पर पहुंची है, जो न सिर्फ मरकज को सैनिटाइज करेगी बल्कि जो आसपास का इलाका है, जो बस्ती है, यहां उसको भी सैनिटाइज किया जाएगा. आपको बता दें कि मरकज में कई कोरोना पॉजिटिव मामले सामने आए हैं. कल 18 मामले हैं, यानी कि तबलीग जमात से जुड़े हुए 18 लोग कल पॉजिटिव पाए गए थे. करीब 250 लोग अलग अलग अस्पतालों में भर्ती हैं. और यहां से अगर आप तस्वीरों में देखेंगे, लगातार लोगों को निकालने का, जो जमाती हैं जो मरकज में मौजूद थे उनको निकालने का सिलसिला लगातार जारी है. उनको क्वारंटाइन किया जा रहा है अलग अलग जगहों पर. छावला कुछ भेजे जा रहे हैं, कुछ बताया जा रहा है झज्जर भेजे जा रहे हैं. उनको क्वारंटाइन करने की जो प्रक्रिया है वो दिखाई दे रही है. मैं आपको अगर दिखाना चाहूंगा, देखिये एक बाकायदा प्रशासन की तरफ से एक कैंप लगाया गया है. कहाँ चूक रह गई, बड़ी लापरवाही थी, लॉकडाउन था, उसके बावजूद यहाँ पर हजारों लोग इकट्ठा थे. क्यों आप लोगों को क्या समझ नहीं आ रहा था कि इतनी बड़ी भीड़ यहाँ पर इकट्ठा नहीं करनी चाहिए?
भीड़ इकट्ठी नहीं की गई है. यहाँ हमेशा का एक रूटीन है, रेगुलर यहाँ मजमा आता है और जाता है. अच्छा. अगर वो इकट्ठा किया जाता है तब की बात है, क्योंकि हमने कॉल करके बुलाया हो. हमने अपना 21 तारीख को, 22 तारीख को पब्लिक कर्फ्यू था, पूरे मजमे को यहाँ से हमने हटा दिया. हमारे पास उसके फोटो मौजूद हैं, जो हमने मजमा यहाँ से पूरा रिलीज किया है.
तो
मेन इज्तिमा था वो 13 से 15 के बीच में था, उसमें कितने लोग थे?
वही 2.5 से 3 हज़ार हमारे होते हैं, 2500-2000 कभी, उसमें कोई ऐसा कोई एक लिमिट नहीं होती है, थोड़ा कम ज्यादा होते हैं।
अच्छा, दिल्ली सरकार ने 16 तारीख को ऐलान किया था कि 50 से ज्यादा लोग इकट्ठे नहीं हो सकते हैं, चाहे वो धार्मिक गैदरिंग हो या किसी और तरह की। उसके बाद 16 तारीख के बाद भी यहाँ पर लोग इकट्ठे रहे, आप पर ये इल्जाम लग रहा है कि आपने फॉलो नहीं किया जो नियम बनाए थे सरकार?
पूरा फॉलो किया है और हर चीज को हम बाकायदा उसी सिस्टम से करते चले आ रहे हैं, एक बार भी हम उससे चूके नहीं हैं। लेकिन बात ये हुई है कि जब वो एक आगे ब्लॉक हो गया है, एक रेगुलर का है ना, पब्लिक हमेशा आती है, अब वो जो रास्ते में उसको कौन रोक सकता है?
5 लोगों से ज्यादा का कंजेशन, कोई भी फंक्शन अलाउड नहीं था, उसके बावजूद भी उन्होंने इस तरह का काम किया है। सरकार ने, मैंने खुद लिख के भेजा है LG साहब को कि इनके खिलाफ सख्त से सख्त कानूनी कार्रवाई की जाए और इनको बख्शा ना जाए। सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग का ध्यान नहीं रखा गया है, एक साथ इतने सारे लोग हैं, अगर तबीयत खराब हो रही है उन्होंने छुपाया, उसको बताया नहीं है, तो इस तरह से लोगों के अंदर बड़ी एक गलत काम किया।
सरकार ने अपनी तरफ से कुछ FIR के आदेश दिए?
जी, दे दिए
आदेश। सर, क्वारंटाइन सेंटर बनाया जा रहा है जवाहरलाल नेहरू स्टेडियम को?
जवाहरलाल नेहरू स्टेडियम को भी केंद्र सरकार ने अलाउ नहीं किया है। अच्छा। बाकी 3 जगह भेजा गया, ऐसा कोई हमारे जानकारी में संज्ञान में नहीं आया कि कोई भी ऐसा कोई फंक्शन किया जा रहा है।
कितने पॉजिटिव केस मिले हैं?
पॉजिटिव केस इसमें टोटल 24 लोगों के पॉजिटिव केस मिल चुके हैं।
Six people have been identified as positive. Many other have been quarantined. And according to latest reports, perhaps 2,000 people have now been quarantined and the entire locality has been cordoned off. Would you classify what happened in Nizamuddin as a community transmission? And if not, then why not?
What has happened today, I'm not fully aware of it. But I can say that if they have quarantined 2,000 people, it's a good job. Because you are trying actually not to allow spread. But let's say these 6 people had it. One of them would probably have had the infection, and maybe the close contacts would have, the 5 or 6 people would have had the infection. So this is generally considered as a, you know, person-to-person transmission. This probably doesn't mean we have a community spread. We have cordoned off the area, the samples must be tested. And I think majority of them might come out to be negative.
This is news just coming in on the Nizamuddin story that is playing out. A massive surveillance and testing system will be put in place along the lines of what South Korea had done. That is something that will happen around the Nizamuddin cluster. Now, what the situation that is emerging in Nizamuddin is very similar to the situation we had seen in South Korea. There will be surveillance, there will be testing. We are being told that in South Korea as well, there was one cult, one church, a secretive church that was blamed for the spread of the coronavirus, where thousands of people who were part of the church were tested positive. South Korea had put measures in place for containment, and those are the things that India is likely to follow as well. I can go across to Sneha Mordani, who is joining us with more details. Sneha, what exactly is the plan of action as far as the Nizamuddin cluster is concerned?
You know, Shreya, I put this question to a source within the government only a few days ago, asking questions about why South Korea is testing so much and why India is not testing as much. In fact, this source did indicate that, you know, our situation is very different from South Korea. But right now, again, it has been confirmed that the situation now is very, very similar. It's a religious congregation in South Korea. Also, the infection, in fact, pretty much really started from the church, where over 5,000 people had attending. Cult was the word that was used also by the source, saying that that is the reason why they had to cordon off this entire area and start checking people, and surveillance testing was done. So surveillance testing was not required until a few days ago in India, but right now what's going to happen is that surveillance testing is going to be done, which means that everybody is going to be treated as a suspected COVID-19 carrier, infection carrier, in that particular area of 3 kilometer radius. The focal point continues to be Nizamuddin. Cordoning off has already happened. Door-to-door visit is going to happen by the team of the Integrated Disease Surveillance Program, where one team comprises of 2 people, and these teams are going to reach out to the people, and this monitoring is going to happen for many, many days. Let me give you a quick example. In the case of Agra, where six people were found, the integrated disease surveillance program workers actually went to 1,60,000 homes for six wow. positive cases. And here in Nizamuddin, right now we have about a confirmation of six people who have died. In fact, 1,600 tests are yet to be carried out. People have been quarantined. The congregation is much larger. The number of people who attended the congregation is 2,000. They have gone back to their respective states and union territories where they came from. So the level of surveillance is going to be multiplied by I just don't know how many times. And these many homes, the people, the integrated disease surveillance program workers are going to attend, check on the people there, look for the vulnerable sections. By vulnerable, I mean anybody even under the age of 60 who has any comorbidity, any underlying illness, that person is going to be isolated and the test is going to be carried out. It's going to be a gigantic effort, a daunting task really, but the effort is going to be just so much more because the people have gone back to the states. So obviously the states are also going to be stepping in. The integrated disease surveillance program to begin with is a coordinated effort of the district, the state and the center. So I think pretty much all hands on deck as far as this big cluster outbreak is concerned. And like I mentioned at the very outset, it appears, and this is through a source again, the situation is extremely similar to what happened in South Korea. In spite of the regulations in place, in spite of the strict protocol of the ICMR, that people coming from foreign countries should in fact be, you know, a quarantine for 14 days, there should be self-quarantine. All of those guidelines, all of those rules have been violated. What sort of action is the government then going to take? And this, of course, qualifies for action under the violation of the Epidemic Act, also violation of Section 144. Correct. These are prohibitory orders in place. We'll get a better sense of that later in the day.
What a complete nightmare this is turning out to be. Sneha Mordani getting us details, our reporters on the ground telling us the extent of contact tracing that will now be required. It's our top story here on CNN News 18. We are putting all our details up on our website, news18.com. There's much more coming up on the other side. Do stay with us.